Our next question is, design a program for forward reverse stop of a motor with mutual interlock. So you have to run the motor in forward direction, reverse direction. We need to stop it with using mutual interlock. So for starting, one start push button is required. Stopping, one stop push button is required. So this Q1 represents motor in forward direction and Q2 represents motor in reverse direction. I3 is for running the motor in reverse direction. I1 is for running the motor in forward direction. I4 is the stop push button for Q2. I2 is the stop push button for Q1. So the question was, the motor should run in forward direction and reverse direction with mutual interlock. That means when it is running in forward direction, Q2 should be off. It should not run in reverse direction. When it is running in reverse direction, it should not run in forward direction. So output feedback needs to be connected here. That means Q2 is on means Q1 should be off. So I am taking Q2 feedback, normally closed, that is not condition. So normally closed condition I am taking for Q2, and that Q2 normally closed condition NC condition I will be connecting to Q1. Likewise, Q1 normally closed condition I will be taking and it will be connected to Q2. I1 is connected to Q1, I3 is connected to Q2. As we are using push button, latching system should be added here. For that one, make contact I am taking and Q1 feedback needs to be given. So once you are releasing this I1 also, Q1 should be in on condition. Same way, here also latching needs to be provided by connecting Q2. So I2, I4 your stop button, I1, I3 is your start button, Q2 and Q1 feedback is given as mutual interlock. This Q1 is given as latching system, this Q2 is given as latching system for Q2. Just we'll simulate and see. We'll change this to push button. So when I am pressing I1, simulating I1 I am pressing means the motor will rotate in forward direction. I3 I am pressing, it will not work. As you are given Q1 feedback. I2 is pressed, Q1 is in off condition. Now I am pressing I3 means Q2 will be in on condition. Now I am pressing I1, Q1 will not come to on position. So at a time only one output will be there, either Q1 or Q2. And I4 I am pressing means Q2 will be off. So I1 for Q1, then I need to stop I1. Then only I can press I3 for Q2. for switching off, I4 I need to press, and at a time only one output will be there.